Google Analytics 4 is a great free tool to analyze all the behavior of user coming into your website, to your Shopify store especially, where you need to constantly analyze the data, which products are being most viewed, and what is the user behavior and intent, and which products are being more bought frequently. Shopify already have their own analytics, but Google Analytics is a way more powerful free tool which you should definitely add on your store, which will also help you with Google Ads integration. So if you have Google Analytics, it will help drive more data to Google Ads if it's connected with Google Analytics. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how you can add Google Analytics 4 to your Shopify store without any code. All you have to do is just follow this video and subscribe to this channel, which will help me, which will help us create more valuable content for you guys. And if you are new to Shopify store and if you want to sign up for a free trial, the link is in the description where you'll be getting a Shopify store for just $1 a month. So let's get into it, where I'll show you guys how to add Google Analytics 4 to your Shopify store. So guys, that's my development store. And here we will add Google Analytics 4. Now, the first step is to create a new Google Analytics 4 account. And in order to do so, what you can do is simply go to analytics.google.com. And I already have Google Analytics properties created for my clients. But what you can do here is click on gear tab on the bottom left corner and click on admin. And then click on this create button here. Click on account. And now we will create a Google Analytics 4 account using our Gmail email. Okay, now let's name our account. I'm going to add testing for YouTube tutorial. And then you can uncheck all of these because these are just for emails and newsletter which you'll be receiving from Google team. So I'm gonna uncheck that. It depends if you want to check it or if you want to receive emails from them. Okay, now click on next. And here I'm going to name my property. Again, I'm just going to name it YouTube tutorial. You can name it as per your website or whatever you want. You can select your time zone here. I'm going to leave it as it is. You can also select the select currency in which you are dealing with your Shopify store. Okay, now click on next. And here you can add some information about your organization. I'm just going to fill in the dummy information. Okay, click on next. And here you can add the intent of the Google Analytics property which you are creating, whether you are looking to generate leads, drive online sales, examine user behavior. So in this case, if you are adding that in Shopify store, you will need to drive online sales and examine user behavior. So check these two items and then click on create. Click on I accept the terms data processing and then click on I accept. Okay, our property has been created and now click on web because we'll be tracking the web platform. You can also create properties for Android app, iOS app, but we are not covering those on this video. So let's click on web. And then you will need to add in your website URL. I'm going to copy my development store URL and then paste in here. And you can name your stream name whatever you want. I'm just going to name it my website. Perfect. This is for enhanced measurement. So enabling that will track the page views, how long they are scrolling on your page, outbound clicks, video engagement, file downloads, form interactions. So all these tracking will be added using Google Analytics to your Shopify store, which is pretty useful to examine user behavior. Okay, now click on create and continue. And here we have our stream is ready. Now what we will do, we will go to our Shopify development store backend and integrate this Google Analytics property. You will see this pop-up. On this pop-up, they have given methods to install, so you can modify events which are being tracked in Google Analytics. You can create your own custom events. Now this is view tag instructions, where you will find the instruction to install Google Analytics on your desired CMS. In our case, we are doing that in Shopify. So if you click on that view tag instructions, you can see we have this install with a website builder or CMS, where we have different type of CMS showing up, and we have the option to install manually. We're gonna go with install with a website builder or CMS, and then click on select your platform. And here we are doing that for Shopify, so click on Shopify. Here what you can do is copy your tag ID and manually do that by adding the code in your theme.liquid file. But what we will do is using an app which is called Google and YouTube app. So let's go to our development store backend. So I'm going to open that in a new tab and go back to the backend. Here we are on our Shopify development store backend, and here we will install an app just as mentioned here, which is called Google and YouTube app. So click on app and then search for Google and YouTube. Then click on this app showing up here, and it will take you to the new tab where you'll have the option to install the app. So that's the app which we will be installing in order to add Google Analytics to our Shopify store. Click on install. It's a free app provided by Shopify, which will automatically integrate your Google Analytics account. Okay. Click on install again. And here we have our Google and YouTube app installed. Now, before connecting your Google Analytics account, I would suggest you to go to your online store from this left-hand menu. And here, click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. And go to your theme.liquid file and make sure that you don't have Google Analytics code already in there. It is one way to check if you have Google Analytics already. So I'm going to go to my theme.liquid file, press Command F, press Control F if you are on Windows. I'm on Mac, so I'm going to press Command F and search for G tag. So this is basically a tag which is used for Google Analytics. So make sure to check that you don't already have Google Analytics installed if you are not a developer yourself. And if developer worked on your theme, maybe a store, then he or she might have installed Google Analytics already. And you need to make sure that there's no duplication in the Google Analytics data. There's one way to check that. And another way is to go to your store and then click on View Page Source. And from View Page Source, you can simply press Command F and search for G tag. Or if you're Windows, you can press Control F to search for G tag. And here, if you are not seeing any G tag, meaning that there is no Google tag already available, and you can safely connect your Google Analytics account, the new one which we created, I'm going to connect that on my development store. Okay, we are back on our Google and YouTube app. Now let's click on connect Google account. And here it's basically asking you to authorize. So I'm going to click on my email through which I created the Google Analytics account. Now it's asking to access the account, click on allow. Now here you can see that we have the option to set up Google Ads conversion measurement. So this is something which I'm not gonna cover on this video. I'm going to create a separate video on how you can set up conversion measurement, conversion tracking for Google Ads. In this video, we are doing the Google Analytics 4. So let's click on get started here. And here you can see our Google account is connected, and you can turn on these notifications if you want to receive emails from Google and YouTube app. And here you will see the Google Analytics property which you created. As you can see, I have multiple properties which are from clients. So I'm going to search for the one which we have created for this video. So from this drop down, I have selected the one after matching my tag ID. You can see G-LX17. So you have to match this if you have multiple Google Analytics properties from this here. So that's my measurement ID when we created the Google Analytics property. I just matched it and select from that drop-down menu. Now click on connect. And here we have successfully set up our Google Analytics 4. Now the final step is to test the data which is being showing up on the Google Analytics. So it may take 4 to 5 minutes to show up the data. Okay, so this is our Google Analytics homepage where you can see there is no data received yet. Now what we will do, we'll add a test order to see if it's collecting all of the events and the data. So that's our store homepage, and just refresh to see if it's collecting the data. So click on this reports here where it will show you the real-time data of your store. Now you can see that it started collecting the data on our real-time reports. And here it's showing me the actual location and the pages and the titles which I am visiting. Now I'm going to add in the test order to see if it's showing up the page views and event name on our real-time report. Now let's go back to the store, click on any product. Let's click on add to cart, click on proceed to secure checkout. And I'm just going to fill in the dummy information to add the test order here. Okay, so our test order has been created. Now let's take a look at the Google Analytics to see if all the events data is being captured properly. So I'm gonna go to the analytics. And here you can see all of the events are being triggered. It first shows that I viewed 8 pages and then I added payment info, user engagement, add to cart, begin checkout. And we should also see the purchase event, which is the final event that the purchase has been successfully made. Now, if you click on this purchase event, you will get the further details about all the currency and all of the details you can see here, right? So you can see the shipping info. You can see the currency that I placed an order in USD, and you can further dig deeper into the event details and get all of the important data which you might need. Transaction ID, you can also get the value as you can see here. So the value of the order which I placed was $39.99. Cool, right? So that's how easy it is to add Google Analytics 4 to your Shopify store. I hope you guys like the video. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to create a tutorial for conversion track measurement in Google Ads. Until next video, have a great day.